Let's get to that question of obstruction of justice, because that really gets to the core of what this investigation is about going forward. We have the advantage of Jeffrey Toobin here. You're a lawyer. James Comey there gives a firsthand account of that meeting with the president soon after the president is elected, when he says the president told him to let the Flynn investigation go. And he said, he is asking me, his impression was to drop the criminal investigation of his now former national security advisor. Is that the evidence of possible obstruction of justice that he's referring to?
I don't think it's evidence of obstruction of justice. I think it is obstruction of justice. I just think, you know, there's just no other way to describe what the president was doing. If Comey's account of the conversation is correct, he is trying to stop an investigation of a subordinate in the Russia investigation. I mean, and particularly when you combine it with all three meetings that Comey talks about, I think in and of itself, it is obstruction of justice. It was a crime committed in the Oval Office. Now, whether Comey was telling the truth, he sure looked like he was telling the truth to me. He sure has a pretty good record on such issues. But, you know, you have to look at all the evidence in the case. But I just think it's a completely devastating account of the president's behavior.
And Laura Coates, do you see it that way?
Well, in part, I think that he did play perhaps an unpersuasive martyr on a lot of things today, but in particular with the obstruction case. See, James Comey is in a very interesting position, because for most of us, we've been following the entire last year and a half and using other pieces of perhaps evidence of obstruction or other things. But for many reasons here, Comey's firing is the beginning of the obstruction inquiry. And for that reason, he can't really fully tell people whether or not everything that conspired between himself and Donald Trump was in fact evidence of it. And remember, we're talking about obstruction. You know, I'm a former federal prosecutor. That was never the end game for me. If I had an obstruction case, that was but a part of my underlying investigation. It would be akin to having an armed robbery and all of a sudden just charging someone with speeding away from the crime. Mm-hmm. It wouldn't be satisfying anyone in the public. And so it is evidence in part of that, but it's not the end game for Mueller. If that is his entire probe, it would be quite ironic and odd if that was the end game for him. It's just not. But is it circumstantial evidence? In part.
Sure. Jason Miller, let's give you a chance to respond. First, if you can, on the obstruction issue, but also just on your larger impression of James Comey's account of the president that you know and you've worked for.
Well, on the first part, I think the president's been very clear, and I think the people around him believe that he can fire the director anytime that he wants, and that there's no obstruction case here, and this is ridiculous.
But how about on the Michael Flynn point is a separate one. Can he tell his FBI director, in the language he used, let it go? An ongoing criminal investigation?
The president and the White House have given a much different account here, but I think it's rather stunning that former Director Comey is in the middle of this. He's out there hawking books to echo on what Dan has said, but also step further, he's out there trying to sell a movie deal. I mean, what we saw tonight didn't feel like some hard-hitting interview. I mean, this felt to me like it was an episode of Behind the Music, where on one shoulder we had Director Comey thinking, well, do I go this way? Or then on the other shoulder was, do I go that way? I mean, the hubris of this man to decide when he has to tell the president who's funding the dossier, or when he goes and brings up, or the politics that played into the fact that he brought up the Hillary email scandal again just before the election. I mean, it came across to me is that former Director Comey has a God complex, and he's the only one who can decide when things are right and when they're wrong.
I know part of the intention here is to turn the fire back towards James Comey, which is fair. He's just put himself out there. He's written the book. But on the facts of this, his account of the facts of this conversation, if the president had asked his FBI director to let a criminal investigation go of his former national security advisor, if you buy James Comey's account, would that be obstruction of justice in your view?
But he didn't. And so I'm saying that Comey is not given an accurate picture here. I think that what we've seen from Comey, I mean, again, he's the only one who can decide when leaking is okay. He's the only one who can decide when lying is okay.